With the stimulus check package now being signed, the next step is to get the money inside of the package out to the American people. According to Jen Psaki at the White House, money could start being electronically deposited as early as tomorrow. Hello and welcome to today's March 12th, third stimulus check package update, as well as trending news. If you're a subscribe member of my community, then welcome back. And if you're not, consider subscribing right now. All right, I just wanted to remind you that this weekend, the 20 winners of the cash contest will be chosen and alerted. There's still two more days to sign up, so try to be one of those 20 winners. Also, I'm happy to announce that next week's giveaway will be a combination of cash, hats, and hoodies to people in the community, so everybody will be able to sign up if they'd like. All right, I'd also like to thank today's video sponsor, FuboTV. Thanks to amazing sponsors like FuboTV, Casey and I have been able to give away over $13,000 to our community, which just makes me so happy to help people with their groceries or a little bit of extra money during these hard times. All right, now today I want to share some updates about the stimulus package situation. Also, I'd like to answer some commonly recurring questions that I see in the community and then share some trending news. As many comments as I get each day, I do try to come on and like them and research them. So I've got some answers for you on some of those questions. With the stimulus check package now being signed by President Biden, the White House's next focus is to start getting this money out to you guys. According to White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki, that will start happening this weekend. So those that have electronic deposits, you could see your money as early as tomorrow, which would be super cool. Now, with the stimulus package being signed, their focus is going to be on getting that money out to the American people. So if you had electronic deposit on the first or second stimulus check, then that's exactly how it's going to be deposited this time. If you got it on the first one but got a paper check, because they're doing it a little bit different this time, it will most likely be deposited electronically. So that $1,400 check will most likely be electronically deposited. Now, if you've received both stimulus checks via a paper check, then it's most likely going to be a paper check again, okay? Now, if you filed your 2020 taxes already and you updated your banking information, you will probably be first in line to get the $1,400 stimulus check. Many in the community are asking me, is there going to be retroactive unemployment this time? The answer is no. So long as the IRS and the Treasury are able to get money over to the different state unemployment offices by the 14th, there should be no delay in the federal unemployment boost payment. If there is a delay, each state will have to make that up to you, but it should only be maybe a 1 or 2 week delay. But because there's no big gap, there is no need for retroactive. I hope that makes sense. College age kids and adult dependents are included in the $1,400 stimulus check this time around. However, the IRS and the federal government have no plans to retroactively pay the $1,200 or the $600 stimulus check to that group of people. It will just be this one-time $1,400 stimulus check. I keep getting that question a lot, so I wanted to make sure to share that with you. As of right now, you don't need to do anything for the $3,000 tax credit other than filing your normal tax return and making sure the IRS is aware of the fact that you have children 17 years old or younger. They will get us more detail, but right now I'm reading that the $250 or $300 monthly child payment could start on July 1st of 2021, and it will go through December of 2021. The rest of the 5 months will most likely be a lump sum once you filed your 2021 tax return. So they're going to do about 6 months worth of payments, and then the remaining 5 or 6 months worth of payments will be a lump sum after you file your taxes. Now, I have a lot more to share with you, but I want to tell you about today's video sponsor and help you guys save some money. I want to thank today's video sponsor, Fubo TV. Did you know that over 80 million Americans believe they pay way too much for cable TV? Well, today I want to show my community not only how to save money by cutting your bill in half, but also how to get all your favorite shows and sports channels. Fubo TV comes with over 100 of your favorite TV channels. Channels like HGTV, Disney, ESPN, Newsmax, BET, and much more. Plus, with Fubo TV, you get to record your favorite shows, so no more missing out on that sports game or your favorite show. Lastly, Fubo TV costs about half as much as cable providers, and you don't have to rent one of those annoying cable boxes. Fubo TV is going to give my community a risk-free trial so that you can try it before you buy it. It only takes about 2 minutes to sign up, and you'll get 15% off your first month. Go to FuboTV.com/Gardner, and to make it easy, I'll make sure to leave a link below. If you're needing rent assistance or landlord assistance, I'm reading that you will want to contact your state office that will be dealing with these benefits. One of the best ways to do that is just to search state benefits in your state, such as the food assistance program, the utilities program, the rent assistance program, or you can call 211 and carefully listen to the different prompts and get in contact. But this is where you'll be able to apply to get that help with the $20 billion that they're releasing, or the $25 billion that they released back in December. That money should be there and available now if you need that rent or landlord assistance. Also, the food assistance program, such as SNAP, did get a 15% increase, and you can apply for that by searching for SNAP food assistance in your state or by calling 211. The SNAP benefit increase will extend through September of this year. It was originally early summer, but they're going to take it through September. If you are behind on taxes, your mortgage, or your utilities, also connect with your local office or call 211, because in this stimulus check package, they're going to release $10 billion to help people that are behind on mortgage, taxes, and utilities. So again, 211 is going to be the hot resource over the next 30 days. When it comes to the federal unemployment weekly boost, gig workers, independent contractors, and self-employed people will be included in the ability to receive help and assistance from these programs. Typically, they're not included in unemployment, but between now and September, that group of workers is also included if you've seen a drop in income or you've lost your ability to produce income from that previous gig work or self-employment. There's going to be $15 billion to replenish the EIDL loan program and also another $7 billion for PPP. You will have to be able to show that you've seen a drop in revenue in order to get access to that business help assistance program. Now, many are asking me about the tax-free part of the unemployment. The first $10,200 will not be taxed. If you received unemployment last year, you will need to let the IRS know on your tax return. If you've already filed a tax return, then you need to do what's called an amendment to your return. Usually a CPA or a tax person can help you with this, but then they will go back and look at the money that you paid taxes on unemployment in the year 2020, and they'll be able to release that to you and send you out a larger tax return. But you do have to let them know. That's a question that's been coming up a lot in the feed. Now, regarding student loan forgiveness, President Biden did not include that in this stimulus bill. It was discussed a lot, but was not included. It might be in a future standalone bill or as an executive order by President Biden. He has said publicly that he would like to forgive up to $10,000 of student loan debt. Many in the far left part of his party are demanding $50,000, but he has said that's most likely too much, and he will just try to push for the $10,000. So more could be coming out about that, but it's not included in this stimulus bill, and you guys have been asking me that a lot in the comments. Also, there was a lot of talk about people on social benefit programs getting a $200 a month boost increase. Biden also did not include that in this stimulus bill. It might be in a later bill or as an executive order, but honestly, I saw a lot of that talk during the election and right after the election, but it's not really being discussed. So I don't think it's going to happen personally, but it was something that was discussed and it was not included. That question keeps coming up, so I just wanted to answer that as well. Also, I'm not seeing that debt collectors will be able to garnish the $1,400 stimulus check. So if that changes, I will come on and let you know. But as of right now, it looks like that money has been protected from debt collectors. Also, it looks like people that are owing back child support will also not have this money taken away. That money will go to that person. And so anyway, that's something else that continues to come up. Before I continue, I just want to say thank you so much for liking these videos and sharing them. I have an awesome, crazy video coming out later today. I would love it if you would go and support that. It's going to be crazy. I can't believe this company said what they said. All right, in trending news, troops are 50 days away from being extracted from Afghanistan. However, with President Biden bombing Syria and having issues with Iran, it's now not clear whether these troops will be pulled out of the Middle East or if they will remain in the Middle East. That is a trending news story as of right now. Lou Otten, the man who invented the cassette tape, has died. Are you old enough to remember cassette tapes and making mixtapes for friends and people you liked? I know I am. Let me know in the comments if you're old enough to remember cassette tapes. All right. Now, this week, Democrats passed two gun reform bills in the House of Representatives. Those will go over to the Senate next week to be debated. It's not clear what kind of traction that will get, but that is something that happened as well in the House of Representatives. Now, this is my update for today. As I know more, I will definitely come on and share more. Make sure to sign up for that cash contest giveaway with 20 winners. It ends in 2 days. So you still have 2 days to put your name in. Also, check out Fubo TV to save money and get access to all of your favorite channels. Before I let you go, I just wish to remind you that you are amazing. I appreciate you being in my community, and I'll see you on the next video.